Good morning, students. Today I'm going to teach you about forfeiture of shares. First, we should know about share. The total capital of the company divided into even units, each unit called share. The share money always collected on installment basis. They may collect on application or on allotment or on calls. Say for example, 10 rupees share. The company collects 2 rupees on application, 5 rupees on allotment and remaining 3 rupees on calls. Now we'll come to forfeiture of share. Share forfeiture means confiscation of share. If any shareholder failed to pay his allotment money or call money, his shares will be confiscated. Confiscation means company will seize the share from the shareholder. Once the shares are confiscated, the shareholder, he should forget about his allotment money and call money what he has already paid. The money paid by the shareholder will be retained by the company. It will not be refunded. Once the shares are forfeited, the shareholder name deprived from the register of shareholder. Once the shares are forfeited, again the forfeited shares can be reissued to the new applicant. The reissue always at lesser than the face value of the share. If the company wants to forfeit the share, the company should follow some condition. Condition number one. The share forfeiture should be authorized by Articles of Association. Two. The forfeiture should be for the non-payment of call money or allotment money. Three. The forfeiture should not be for the non-payment of any other debt due by the shareholder. Fourth condition is, before forfeiture of share, the company has to give 14 days due notice. It is also called reminder to the shareholder. After giving 14 days notice, the default continues. The company forfeits the share. When shares are forfeited, the share capital of the company will be reduced.